Hi, welcome to the 24th lecture in this lecture series introducing international investment law. So far, we have seen three substantive protections in international investment law. One, fair and equitable treatment protection. This was covered in lectures 15 to 18. And full protection and security standard, which was covered in lectures 19 to 21. And the non-impairment standard, which was covered in lectures 22 and 23. In this lecture, we will discuss another substantive standard, that is the umbrella clause. The umbrella clause is a provision in an investment treaty that guarantees observations of obligations by the host state vis-a-vis the investor. For instance, Article 10, Sub-Article 1 of the Energy Charter Treaty provides, among other things, each contracting party shall observe any obligations it has entered into with an investor or an investment of an investor of another contracting party. Basically, the umbrella clause elevates a contractual obligation between the investor and the host state to the level of an interstate obligation that is incorporated in the investment treaty. These clauses were previously known as mirror effect, elevator, parallel effect, sanctity of contract, and respect clauses, but are now known generally as umbrella clauses. We will see more about this clause in greater detail later. Now, we look at how these clauses evolved. Like many other concepts in investment law, this clause owes its origin to oil concessions. In 1953-1954, Mr. Elihu Lauterpacht advised the Anglo-Iranian Oil Company as regards settlement of the Iranian oil nationalization dispute. Later, in 1956-1957, a group of oil companies proposed a trunk pipeline from Iraq through Syria and Turkey to the eastern Mediterranean. Once again, Mr. Lauterpacht advised the oil companies to use this clause. Later, in 1956-59, the clause found its place in Article 4 of the 1956-59 ABS draft International Convention for the Mutual Protection of Private Property Rights in Foreign Countries, which read, "Insofar as better treatment is promised to non-nationals than to nationals, either under intergovernmental or other agreements or by administrative decrees of one of the high contracting parties, including most favored nation clauses, such promises shall prevail." It may be noted that Lauterpacht was closely involved in drafting of this convention. In 1959, the above clause was reformulated as follows. Each party shall at all times ensure the observance of any undertakings which it may have given in relation to investments made by nationals of any other party. Interestingly, the first BIT between Pakistan and Germany in the year 1959 contained this clause. It read, "Either party shall observe any other obligation it may have entered into with regard to investments by nationals or companies of other party." In 2004, it was estimated that about 40% of the BITs contained this clause. The languages in these BITs are not uniform. There are many versions of the umbrella clause, and therefore the wordings might have implications on the scope of the protection offered by it. Although many umbrella clauses use mandatory language such as shall observe, as we saw in the Germany-Pakistan BIT, some treaties do not have this mandatory language. For instance, Article 10 of the Australia-Poland BIT of 1991 used a less forceful language. It read, "A contracting party shall, subject to its law, do all in its power to ensure that a written undertaking given by a competent authority to a national of the other contracting party with regard to an investment is respected." Some umbrella clauses go to the extent of dealing with private transactions between the investor and another party in the host state, although these clauses predominantly deal with state action. Article 15 of the Czech Republic Singapore BIT of 1995 provides, "Each contracting party shall observe commitments to those specified in this agreement it has entered into with respect to investment of investors of the other contracting party. Each contracting party shall not interfere with any commitments additional to those specified in this agreement entered into by nationals or companies with the nationals or companies of the other contracting party as regards their investments. Thus, the exact scope of the umbrella clause may depend on its wordings in the treaty. More on this in the next lecture. Bye bye and stay safe. The references used in this lecture are available in the description to this video.